Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The ceremony will begin in approximately 2 minutes. This is considered an outdoor ceremony conducted indoors. Military members are reminded to remain covered and render appropriate salutes. As a courtesy to those around you, please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices for the duration of the ceremony. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Commanding General, Brigadier General Jason E. Kelly, and the Post Command Sergeant Major Eric Oakes, welcome to the United States Army Training Center and Fort Jackson for the graduation of Companies B and C of the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment, 193rd Infantry Brigade. Please stand for the invocation given by Chaplain Woodley Pierre.
Please join me in prayer. Dear Lord, as we gather here today to recognize and celebrate the accomplishment of this graduating class, Lord, we thank you for your provision of strength over the last 10 weeks. Thank you, Lord, that victory indeed starts here at Fort Jackson. We are grateful for the dedication, motivation, and discipline instilled over the course of basic combat training, as well as the necessary endurance to succeed. As these soldiers overcame hardships, anxieties, fears, they earned the right to truly call themselves U.S. Army soldiers. And now, Lord, they are fit to go live as examples of the Army values. On today, Father, I pray a special blessing over their future training, travel, as well as life. Father, I thank you for their families, and I pray a blessing upon their families, God. And Father, also, forget not to bless the United States of America. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Please be seated. The purpose of today's ceremony is to recognize the commitment of the men and women you see standing in formation before you who have chosen to serve their country as soldiers. This review is the last official formation of the training cycle. Not everyone successfully completes this difficult period of training, but those in formation today represent disciplined, motivated, physically fit soldiers who exemplify the Army's 7 core values: loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. They are imbued with the warrior ethos and display the tenets of putting the mission first, never accepting defeat, never quitting, and never leaving behind a fallen comrade. This is an important day, and these soldiers can take great pride in their accomplishments. To the families and friends of these soldiers, Fort Jackson extends a very warm and sincere welcome. We are justifiably proud of them and are equally honored that they have chosen to join our ranks. Please direct your attention to the left of the formation. The units marching today, from your left to right, are graduating soldiers from Company B, the Battalion Color Guard, and graduating soldiers from Company C. Located on the upper level and providing music for today's ceremony is the 282nd Army Band under the command of Chief Warrant Officer 3, Kevin Pick. Identified by their distinctive headgear are the drill sergeants. These dedicated, non-commissioned officers form the backbone of the Army's training center system. Selected on the basis of professional competence, leadership ability, and years of service, these men and women undergo intensive training to earn the right to wear their distinctive hat and insignia. With the drill sergeant hat goes the important responsibility of molding civilian men and women into soldiers. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Major Fred J. Grooms, Jr., who serves as the battalion executive officer for the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment. He and the battalion staff are positioned on the floor. The reviewing officer for today's graduation is the commander of the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment, Lieutenant Colonel Dennis A. Cook. On his left is Command Sergeant Major Ricardo Moreno, the battalion's senior non-commissioned officer, master trainer, and principal advisor to the commander. The commander of troops will now bring forward the colors and persons to be honored. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the national anthem. It is appropriate for soldiers not in uniform and all Armed Forces veterans to salute the American flag. We ask our civilian guests to please remove your headgear and place your right hand over your heart as our national anthem is played. The soldiers most responsible for the training of these soldiers are the drill sergeants, who are carefully selected by the Department of the Army. The drill sergeant campaign hat and badge have been a stoic symbol of professionalism and pride since 1962. At this time, all past and present drill sergeants, please stand as the drill sergeant of the cycle for the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment recites the drill sergeant creed.
Drill Sergeant Creed. I want still pride in all I trade, pride self in the Army and in country. I will insist that each soldier meets and maintains the Army standards of military bearing and courtesy, consistent with the highest tradition of the U.S. Army. I will lead by example, never requiring a soldier to attempt any task that I would not do myself. But first, last, and always, I am an American soldier, sworn to defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, both foreign and domestic. I am a drill sergeant. This will defend
to the end.
Lieutenant Colonel Cook and Command Sergeant Major Moreno will now present the awards. The Outstanding Drill Sergeant of the Cycle for the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment is Drill Sergeant Nathan Chavis from Wilmington, North Carolina. The Soldier Leader of the Cycle for Bravo Company is Specialist Maxwell Jeffrey from Ferndale, Washington. The Soldier of the Cycle for Bravo Company is Specialist Mason Lorber from Danville, Iowa. The Soldier Leader of the Cycle for Charlie Company is Sergeant Brian Golke from Chesterfield, Virginia. The Soldier of the Cycle for Charlie Company is Specialist Joseph Doria from Ocean Pines, Maryland. Ladies and gentlemen, the Commander of the 3rd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment, Lieutenant Colonel Dennis A. Cook.
Good morning, everyone. I hope everybody enjoyed their family day yesterday. Nobody got in trouble. Everybody followed the rules. Thank you. I appreciate it. You make my life a lot easier that way. To start off the day, I want to say welcome, Major General Harder, Colonel Storer. Thank you for coming today. Distinguished guests, supporting staff and cadre, friends and families present, and those tuning in around the world, thank you for being here for today's ceremony, and welcome to your soldier's graduation. Since 1917, Fort Jackson has helped forge America's warrior class as it transforms civilians into disciplined, competent, professional American soldiers. In short, Fort Jackson is responsible for manufacturing tomorrow's heroes, and it produces them at a rate of more than 48,000 soldiers per year, which is more than half of the Army's requirement. This is why we at Fort Jackson proudly proclaim that victory truly starts here, and that we make American soldiers. Today, that tradition continues as we welcome 522 of America's newest defenders of freedom into our ranks and mark their graduation from basic combat training. Throughout time, the conduct of war has changed and will continue to change. But through it all, the one constant that remains is people. We are a people business, and we are in the business of producing and continuing to develop the best people to be our soldiers, non-commissioned and commissioned officers. I am very proud to be a part of that, and I promise you that our future is in good hands with those that are standing in front of you today. That said, we must recognize that our present is shaped by our past, and I want to start by recognizing our veterans and retirees. We are a free nation because of the sacrifices of American service members who have fought for and continue to fight for our freedoms. Can all the veterans and retirees please stand to be recognized? In addition, please help me in remembering the prisoners of war and those still missing in action by They will truly never be forgotten. Above me is the 282nd Band. We have the privilege of having one of the best bands in the Army right here at Fort Jackson. And they always add something special to this ceremony. So please help me in applauding them. The next group of individuals I would like to recognize are our cadre, and most importantly, the drill sergeants that transform your loved ones from civilians into American soldiers. Your soldiers will forget some of their peers, some of their experiences will fade away, and they will most certainly not remember my comments today. But they will always remember the names of their drill sergeants. Years from now, they will tell you that they could not have done it without their drill sergeants. Drill sergeants are specially selected from across the Army and undergo rigorous training at the Drill Sergeant Academy right here at Fort Jackson. On a daily basis, they display the attributes of a soldier and demonstrate the Army values of loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. They have spent the last 10 weeks working hard to ensure your soldiers made it through basic combat training with the tools to be successful at their first unit of assignment. Working alongside the drill sergeants, we have a host of company commanders, first sergeants, platoon leaders, support cadre and staff, and they move mountains on the daily in support of the mission here. They fully recognize the responsibility of their charge, which is caring for and developing America's most precious resource, which are your sons and daughters, brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers. It is never taken lightly by any of them, and for that, I cannot thank them enough for what they so selflessly give every day. Please help me in recognizing their tireless efforts and the selfless service to the mission here at Fort Jackson. Now to the families, teachers, coaches, mentors, and friends watching this ceremony today, either live or virtually, I want to say thank you. Thank you for your support and your trust in us to transform your loved ones. They would not be here without any of you. And what amazing group these soldiers are. The resilience this class has shown is a testament to their strength and maturity. Furthermore, these soldiers speak to the richness and diversity that constitutes the strength of our nation since its beginning over 248 years ago. I would like to talk about the graduating soldiers who are standing on the field before you. Here are some interesting facts about this class. They're quite a diverse group. The youngest soldier is 17. The oldest is 42. They come from 37 different states and territories, 37 different countries, and speak 29 different languages. Many soldiers in this formation have college degrees. 40 have their associate's degree. 91 have their bachelor's degree. 16 have a master's, and one even has their PhD. 7 soldiers have crossed over from sister services, and lastly, 3 soldiers were former non-commissioned officers and decided to volunteer once again. Yet despite their unique and diverse backgrounds, what unites all of them is that each one of these soldiers has raised his or her right hand and sworn to support and defend the Constitution of the United States. Please help me in recognizing our newest soldiers. Now to the graduating soldiers. All of you arrived at Fort Jackson as individuals. Some likely for adventure, others out of sense of duty. Some of you just wanted to be a part of something larger than yourselves, while others sought a different purpose or another direction in life. But you all answered the call to duty and leave as American soldiers. We are proud of you. We saw you all develop and grow strong over the last 10 weeks. You need to be proud of yourselves and what you have accomplished. Remember, stay motivated, disciplined, and continue to live by the Army values 24 hours a day so that when our nation calls, you are ready. No one handed this to you. You have earned the privilege and honor to call yourself a United States Army soldier. I wish all of you the best in your future careers. To our extended Army families, thank you again for your attendance, whether it be online or in person, and your tremendous support to our soldiers in this nation. Families and friends, please continue to help and support your new soldiers. They have become something different, something better than they were. They are now part of the greatest army in the world. 40 rounds, no ground to give, and victory. Come on, guys, sleep in one more time. Let's go. So 40 rounds, no ground to give, and victory.
Today's soldier is above all a warrior, adaptive, confident, and competent. As a soldier, you are totally committed to the warrior ethos, grounded in Army values, and determined to destroy enemies of the United States of America and her allies. The United States Army Soldiers' Creed embodies this commitment. To the soldiers on the floor, the uniform you wear at this moment is more than an outward display of your vocational choice. Your uniform is a symbol of a nation and an unspoken assurance to all who see you that you are a willing and able protector of the freedoms fought so arduously by all who have gone before and those who will bravely come after. You have become what you set out to be, a soldier in the United States Army. The Soldier's Creed is your declaration of your unshakable commitment to the ideals this nation was founded upon and will continue to guarantee. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as Sergeant Golke leads the soldiers standing before you through the reciting of the Soldier's Creed.
I am a soldier. I am a warrior member of the team. I serve the people of the United States and this country.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. On behalf of the Commanding General and the men and women of Fort Jackson, thank you for attending today's basic combat training graduation. Family members and friends, please remain seated until all soldiers have left the floor before exiting the auditorium in a safe and orderly manner. Please remember to take all trash and personal items with you. Once again, thank you for your attendance. Have a safe journey home.